Okay, so that was kind of a ridiculous example of a faked lightning bolt in a video. So I'm going to show you how I did this. I put this together in about 10 minutes. The whole point of this video is to show you how easy it is to create a fake lightning bolt video. So the first thing I did is I went through my still photos and I found a nice image of lightning. And I'm in the old PaintShop Pro here, so this isn't even Photoshop. So just use the magic wand tool and select the bolt, copy and paste, and then I get this, which is the outline of the bolt that I'm going to use in my fake video. So I'm going to save this as a PSD, and then I'm going to go over here to Photoshop, and I've kind of jumped ahead here for time's sake. So here's the base image I made. And then I made a second version right here. And I just added an outer glow effect to make it nice and intense looking. So what I did is I took those PSD files and imported them straight into Premiere. And I'm gonna just drag this slider so you can see frame by frame what I've done here. Okay, so some of the layers that are in here, a white color mat, which is basically a white out. It makes it look like there's a bright flash illuminating the whole scene. And I've got that frame by frame at different opacity levels here, so it brightens and dims as the lightning flickers. I brought the fake lightning image, or the actual bolt from this picture here, into the frame there with the outer glow. You can see it there. And then I made another video layer here and applied a brightness contrast effect to make the whole scene kind of white out like it would if there was a bright lightning flash. And the last thing I did is I went into my video footage archives and got a video clip of an actual close lightning strike and brought that into the audio track and synced it up right there with the fake lightning bolt. And I also added a bunch of volume boosters here to make it sound ridiculously close. So there you have it. It took me about 15 minutes to do, and it's really not all that refined. If I had more time, I could put a little bit more thought and effort into it, but as you can see, it's not that difficult to make one of these things, and that's my point. So the best way to identify a fake lightning video, or lightning photo for that matter, is to become familiar with what real lightning looks like. When you know what real lightning looks like, it's not that hard to spot the fakes. So I'm going to show you a clip here of lightning hitting a TV tower. This is zoomed in, so it's a pretty close image, probably a good approximation of what a lightning bolt is going to look like if you were on the beach and a lightning bolt struck 50 feet away from you, or somewhere around there. Now, what I want you to notice, the most important thing about this clip, the reason I'm showing it to you, is look what happens when the lightning starts to dissipate. And this is what's called the bead out phase, or what I call bead out. It's beading. The lightning channel breaks up into beads, and sometimes there'll be another return stroke like there is there. But you see how the lightning just doesn't disappear. It beads out. And all lightning does this to some degree. Now, you're not going to be able to see this beading if you're far away from the channel. You're only going to see this if you're really up close. And if you take a look at the legitimate close lightning videos on YouTube, then there are plenty of them. And in the description of my video, I'm going to link to some of those so you can look and see what real lightning looks like up close. But you see those beads? If you don't see those beads right after a lightning strike, that's a reason to suspect the video isn't legitimate. That doesn't mean it's not legitimate. Again, you're not going to see these beads if you're not right up there next to the lightning bolt. But if you're right there, if the lightning strike is right there in front of you and you don't see those beads, that's a good reason to be suspicious. The other feature that you're going to want to look for in a close lightning video is at the bottom of a lightning channel, there almost always is some kind of an orange glow. The lower part of the channel, maybe the first 10, 20 feet of the channel above the water, is going to be orange in color. And if you look at all of the other close lightning videos that are on YouTube, and again, I'm going to have some of those in the video description here, but you're going to see that orange segment of the channel right above the water surface. If you don't see that, it's a good reason to be suspicious of the video. So that's it. Just wanted to give you some information that'll hopefully help you spot some of these fakes that are popping up. As software gets more sophisticated, it's going to be easier and easier to make these. And I suspect that this isn't going to be the last one that we see. So just apply a little critical thinking to the videos that you see floating out there, and you'll be able to spot some of the fakes.